Good evening, community viewers. I am just getting Outcast squared away. So I have some good vibe music going.
DJ in the house. Hey,
can you see me?
I see you.
Am I bright? Because it looks dark. I don't know. You look great.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Come through with the energy.
Girl, I stay with the energy, man. You know, it really helps when you work out and you meditate, you know.
No, this is all natural.
No, all natural, no coffee, none of that.
No, I love it. Looking good.
Thank you. And so do you. I was trying to share it on my page. I was like, well, I wish I could have shared it on my page, but it's all good.
Yeah, I actually, earlier today, I actually like tagged you. So, you know, that way, like, you can have it. So maybe it was just a little bit on the late end. I apologize for that. But they can always kind of like come back and like tune in, you know,
okay,
which is
okay.
The part. All right. So I'm going to go ahead.
You look great. Let me just say this. Let me acknowledge it. You look fantastic. The hair is on fleek. The makeup is doing well. The lip is good. You look great. I just wanted to say that.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. All right. So we're going to just jump straight into it.
Yes.
Welcome to another week of 40 Minutes for You. You know, I've been talking to some friends, and I just really feel like we're in this same space. And one of the common discussions is just our passion. You know,
right.
I realize that people are really taking that passion to new heights. You know, they're starting their own business ventures. Mm-hmm. And I really want to make sure that our community is always have this progressive, forward way of thinking. You
right.
know, because this pandemic is over, you know, I know there are going to be like so many different job opportunities available. And so when people are coming to the table, you know, sometimes it's not just what you bring to the table, but it's how you bring it to the table.
Absolutely.
And so that brings us to this week's topic, the power of negotiation, no more asking for permission. And so I'm so glad, you know, to have a former colleague, a friend, an inspirationalist, an etiquette therapist, Natasha St. Amand, who is our guest for tonight. And she's going to just unpack this topic and just share like a wealth of information, give us tools that we can put under our belt, and really make sure that when we do put ourselves out there, that we're prepared. And so, you know, let's just jump straight into it. And I'm doing better with shout outs. So, you know, shout out to Wes for joining in, you know. Thank you. Welcome. So one of the things that I was saying earlier is, you know, I was talking to one of my girlfriends and she was telling me that she went on this job interview. And basically, you know, it's that one conversation where people really start to tiptoe around, you know, when it's time to talk about money. And so the employers made her an offer. She felt like it was below her worth. She tried to counter it, but they were just like, no, this is the final number. And so she felt obligated and she took it, you know, and I just want us to kind of like talk about that today. You know, why is it so important for us to really understand this tool called negotiation?
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna be honest with you. It comes with your level of understanding your value. Your value, right? Because everything, it's all about what you see yourself as and how you perceive everyone else should see, right? Because it has to start within, right? And so with your friend, you know, who went on this job interview, she had a salary in mind, right? She had a salary in mind. However, the salary that they proposed was apparently a lot lower than what she had expected. Okay. Mm-hmm. And so even as she said, I would prefer, they still said, no, that's not going to work. Now, the question, of course, is why did she take it? Did she take it? Because there are a number of reasons why people may take a job. Is it because that is their last thing, that they feel like, I need a job, I'm unemployed? Or did she have options, right? Did she have options? But I'm often say when I talk to, you know, as an etiquette therapist, and can I just quickly explain what an etiquette therapist is, really?
Yes, we can plow straight to that. Yes.
Okay, yeah, because oftentimes, okay, so Natasha Paris, you know, for me, as an etiquette therapist, and this is two of my worlds coming together because they used to live in tandem. And so as an etiquette trainer, what I did was I worked with models, Miss Black USA. I worked with a lot of individuals, men. I was a stylist. I was a makeup artist. I worked for MTV. I did a lot of the behind the scenes, was also a model, did a lot of fashion shows, a lot really helping to create that etiquette scene, right? In addition to understanding protocols, right? Did that for a very long time. But at the same time, I was living this other life as a licensed clinician like you, right? Like Miss Boston, living that life as a clinician, working with families, working with individuals, you know, and I realized that those two worlds were not so separate. They were actually working in conjunction without knowing it. And so what is it that I do as a consulting firm along those lines is I really support individuals from the perspective where I am helping not just on the outside, like the nonverbal and the verbal, the nonverbal being able to walk into a room and command attention without having to speak, right? Mm-hmm. And that comes from right here. And also, from the inside, helping individuals from a emotional stability, but also confidence building, and how do you feel about yourself? And so all of those two things, I mean, it's a major, those two worlds have come together. So when I talk about being an etiquette therapist, I really talk about individuals being able to not necessarily negotiate who you are. Let's talk about that. Not negotiating who you are, because if you negotiate who you are, then people will put in an offer that may be completely low than what you are deserving, right? And so if you come in with an expectation, right, I always tell my clients, go high, right? If you want to make $100,000, if that is the goal for you, right, in this day and age, that's not a whole lot, but $100,000, you you say, I want 115, and then they'll bring it there, right? But if you're a $100,000 girl or a man, and you know that for sure because of your skill set, because of your experiences, because of what you bring to the table as it relates to your commitment and your dedication and your loyalty, and they give you an offer of $70,000 for the position that you know is worth much more, then you take a bet on yourself and you take that chance and you walk. But again, this is about your confidence, because are you going to be able to sit at that company knowing your value and being treated less than? Because guess what? That will not last very long. It will begin to eat at you internally because you know what you give. So it, as it relates to that, I would honestly say that you look at how you value yourself and what you expect people to value, how you value you, because it's
okay. So you're breaking up. I'm not sure if you see.
Am
yourself.
I breaking up? I'm not.
Yes.
Really.
Do you see
yourself? Am I breaking up? I'm sorry. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, so it could be kind of like the location, that you're in?
Right, because normally this is my location where I do a lot of Zoom calls, so I normally don't have much difficulty, so I'm not sure why. I don't know. I have, so literally you didn't hear anything I said, right? Is that what you're saying?
No, I hear you, but the picture is disfigured.
Oh.
For some reason. But it looks clear on your end. So viewers that's chiming in, can you see Natasha?
Thumbs up, write a comment, because yeah.
Okay, now you're coming back. Right, that was very mystical looking.
What happened?
Now you just magically kind of came back. So you're good to go. You're good to go.
Technology, right? We're at the disposal of technology.
No, but what you were saying, I could still hear you. And you said something that I really wanted to touch a little bit on. You were saying that it's so important to have confidence. And, you know, sometimes the inability to negotiate is foreign because the prerequisites aren't there to carry that skill out. And so what do you do? You know, especially, you know, what I love about this platform is like tying it in back to like mental health, you know, so how can your mental health impact your ability to execute this skill? And for those who may be joining in, whether it's now or later, and they want to know like, hey, I have to admit, you know, I'm a beach, vulnerable, you know, vulnerable and transparent. You know, confidence wasn't something that always came easy. You know, it was something that had to be cultivated. You know, so what would you say are some strategies and some tools that people can actually start to put into play until they have that confidence?
Well, you know what? Let me say this. Okay, can you hear me? Am I visible? Am I not disfigured? Okay, just let me know, okay? All right, so there are three things that I would honestly say that a person can do to increase their level of confidence. The first thing is that you need to begin, and I'm a Christian, and I'm going, and the Bible is what I use. Go [S2] Yes. [S1] To the Bible. Go to the Bible and look at what the particular scriptures that talk about what God says about you. That I am fearfully and beautifully made. That no weapon formed against you shall prosper.
Yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. Like looking at particular scriptures that God said He would never leave you nor forsake you. That says that He has a great plan for your life. Right. Looking at those particular scriptures and then taking it a step further and writing it down. And then writing it down, meditating on it, and posting it in areas within your household that you frequent. Mm-hmm. Right? Putting it on index cards. Or just even going further with that and writing down, you can do it. You can do it. Or you deserve everything that God has in store for you. Because you are who you are and God is who He is to you. Like certain things, like you need to speak life into your own life, right? And that comes through being able to say it and say it to the point where you begin to believe it. If you have to say it 20 to 30 times a day, then you do that. But then also take it another step further, look in the mirror and say it. Speak to yourself, look at yourself in the eyes and say, I love you. You deserve it. You, and not just that you deserve it, but it is your right. It is your right. Yeah. It is your right to have the abundance of what is available for you. And so when you talk about tips, that is, I mean, there's so many other things. I mean, I can go on and on and on. I actually have a master class happening. And I'm starting a new class that starts on Tuesday. I'm super duper excited, where I'm literally helping women in particular who have these concerns that prevent them from moving forward, prevent them from going after those salaries, going after those entrepreneurial positions and titles, and not just that, being okay with being okay, right? Like, it's called the three M's of mastery, right? Resetting your mind, your money, and your moves, how you move in the world.
Wow, powerful.
Right. Uh-huh. So those are my tips and needs. And I go in detail with, it's a 6-week course, super, super excited about it. And we can talk about joining next time. I'm having another course that starts in February 1st. But yes, absolutely. Those are my tips, right? The basics.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Thank you for that. And, kind of just going a little bit deeper with it. So that was speaking more so about the mental part, now kind of going to, I am about to ask for X, Y, and Z. So how do people actually begin to prepare and maybe even sharpen their skill so they can have the leverage to actually negotiate? Because you can't say, I want this, this, and this. And then when it's time to actually execute, you may be a little bit like a fish out of water. So, I want to make sure that people just have like that balanced perspective.
I'm glad you asked. I'm glad you mm-hmm. asked. Because faith without works is what? Dead, right? Yes.
Right.
So faith without works is dead, right? You can have all the faith, but if you don't have any work to back it up, then it's completely dead, right? And so one of the things that I will often say to people, research the company that you are interviewing with. Research the company you're interviewing with. One. Two, research the position that you are going after. If you've never gone after that particular position and you feel you're qualified from your other experiences, look at the position that you're going after. Third, look at what the salary, what is the average salary for that particular position? And yes. If you are lacking that particular qualification within that position, then guess what? Do your homework and get to studying. Get to studying. And then begin to look at what you've done in the past and see how it relates to the position and the qualifications that comes with that particular position. So when that question is asked, you can easily, and you with confidence and boldness, you can easily say, I have done this. I know my resume may not say that I worked in that position, right? So what about me? Who says? You look great. we both look great. This afternoon. I just love the comments. She does. She's gorgeous.
Gorgeous. I cannot with you tonight. I cannot. And you too. That's my homegirl, Gio. She just coming out to support,
you know I bring the antics, right? I can't be anything else, right? But oh my goodness. Oh, thank you, girl, thank you. Seriously, so we digress. It's always good to laugh.
No, it's fun. So much fun. Yes.
Laughing is good for the soul, But my point is this, is that really do your homework. Because you don't want to go into a position or you don't want to go into a position in an interview and not be prepared, because you can look great on the outside and then they ask you a question and you're like, blah, 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 and that, that, and you're stumbling over your words. But if you go in with confidence and you're prepared, the chances of you being successful at that position, I should say during that interview, shoots up. And then also most organizations like when you have done research. Like that you know about the company and how long and when they were established and who the CEO is and what they've done in the past, right? That fits into your goals and purpose. Because remember, they're not just interviewing you. You are interviewing them. We have to always remember that. You're interviewing them. Is this a good fit for me? Because remember, people are not, do not go chasing after something. You want to find a middle ground. Do you fit my, what it is that I'm looking for as it relates to my career advancements, right? Does that work for me too? Because when you go in like that, oh, the energy is felt. But if you go in desperate, they sense it, they feel it, and then they try to manipulate.
Wow. And I love that. And you know what? And I feel like this has been like a common theme, you know, throughout, you know, the different IG lives that I've done, is you have to have like alignment there, you know, on both ends. And like you said, yes, we want the position, but at the same time, you're bringing something of asset to the table as well. Yes. You know, and it's kind of like a partnership. And I remember I heard someone, you know, doing, I did a lot of different business consultations for my own business. And the one thing that he said that really stood out is you need to know your own mission, your own value, your own philosophy. Yes. So like you said, when you are going to interviews and you may say, wow, they have everything that you could think of, but something could be off. You know, because you have to go there every single day, or you have to be that person's partnership. You know, it's a business now. Now y'all partners, and y'all have to be able to relate every single day. Yes. So that's just something, when you said that, that really brought me to that point. So thanks for that.
Of course. We have to always remember that we are deserving of everything that we want, right? Because desires have not just been put into our spirit to want it. God put it there. And because he put it there, he's equipped you with everything necessary in order to achieve it. And you have to remember that.
Yeah, and you know, sometimes, and you know, you're a therapist as well, a lot of times in our field, you have therapists who say, you know, hey, I feel inadequate. You know, last week we had Gio as our guest speaker talk on imposter syndrome. And I love how you were just saying, if you want to get better, if you want to be able to be fruitful, immerse yourself, you know, do the research, you know, really go into the nuts and bolts of what you want to do until you master it. So this brings me to my next question, you know, for you. When you kind of look back over your whole timeline of experiences, what was that final straw for you that said, hey, no more asking for permission. I'm about to take my career to new heights, because you have definitely.
I'm trying.
So what was that breaking point when you were just like, I'm about to do something out of the box, a new commitment to me, and I'm going with it?
Okay, I'm so humbled by that question, because it really, there have been two incidents, right? And that those breaking points, actually everything happens exactly how it's supposed to happen. We may not always understand why, but it happens. The first was when I had made a decision to do and focus on me, right? And do me from the perspective of, I have to heal my mind. I have to heal my money. I have to heal my moods, which, as I was saying, this is bringing me to why I'm doing this masterclass for 6 weeks for women, right? I speak about that is, I had gone through a wilderness situation in my life. That was the first. A wilderness situation in my life where I basically lost everything. Mm-hmm. I had gone through a divorce. Mm-hmm. I had two babies to feed. I lost my job. I was on the verge of eviction. I had gone through all of my savings. I only had $25 in my bank account. And I was crying every day. I couldn't understand how I could get through this. The pain, the darkness, the hopelessness was there. And it wasn't until, And mind you, I was 3.5 months behind in my rent. Landlord knocking on my door. No job, had all these degrees. No job, couldn't find a job. And I was like unemployed for 4 months.
Wow.
Very, very hard time for me.
Wow.
But what got me up, despite my wilderness, despite, and I talk about the wilderness is because if you know the Bible, the wilderness is a place of despair. It's a place of darkness. It's a place of hopelessness. Many people, especially during COVID, are going through their wilderness, not being able to see their hand before their face because it's so dark. But how was I able to get out of that darkness and move into my promised land where fruit and honey was in abundance was when I decided to bet on me. When my daughter came to me and said to me, at 3.5 years old, I was in the midst of crying, didn't hear her walking up to me. She startled me. As a parent, you try to cover your children from your own pain. And she startled me and she tapped me on my shoulder and said, Mommy, why you cry? Mommy, why you cry? And it was at that moment I realized that I had to stop being pitiful for me, stop crying, stop being upset. Even though the landlord was knocking on my door, even though I had no money, even though I couldn't find a job, I had to get myself together for who? For my children. I realized I had to bet on me and start acting and doing what was necessary despite what was going on. And it was when I decided to bet on me because I had other had children to take care of. I realized enough is enough. One, that was the first incident. Years later, what made me decide to jump from being a 9-to-5er? And no shame to those who work a 9-to-5. What made me decide to make that jump was then when I worked for a company and they knew my assets and they knew what I brought to the table. They knew I was also an etiquette trainer. They hired me in addition to the position that I was working with because I was with them for some time. Mm-hmm. They knew that I had this skill set. They said, we have a grant that we are working towards. We understand that you have done this work in the past and probably are still doing it part-time. And we were wondering if you could support us on this grant. Contract, more so a contract. I said, sure. And the person said to me, well, we will just pay you, like, just add it to your salary. Well, it was like not even adding it. It's part of your job mission. I said, oh, no. What I paid for was not that. It was this. This is how much I charge. When I brought the proposal to the company, the owner of the company, and said, this is how much I will charge you to do this contractual work so you can put my name on this contract, my licensing and my experience.
Mm-hmm.
They laughed at me. Laughed. Mm-hmm. And I said, wow. I counter offered and they still went below. But what I decided to do was I said, I am going to take it, not knowing how much the contract was. I'm going to take it just from the experience perspective. He was going to still pay me, but from the experience perspective. But what was the needle that broke the camel's back is when I finally found out how much the contract was worth. The contract was worth $800,000 that he was being paid for to facilitate this contract. And I was the main source of the facilitation, and I was being paid less than 2% of that contract that he had received. And it was at that point I said, never will I do that again. And it was at that point I said, if I can do this for someone who is paying me less than 2%, why not do it for myself? That's when I jumped. And I said, I'm going to jump off of this skyscraper 100 flights down. And I know that God has me because wings are going to develop right under here. Right up, going to go from my shoulder blades because God is going to catch me before I fall because I went in with good intentions. Now I know I have the experience to say that now I know how to go into an office, go into government offices like DOES in DC, go into, you know, Volunteers of America and say, this is what I do. This is how much I charge. And every time after that, I got.
Wow.
Are you still there?
It kind of is doing that tech issue again.
You went out and then came back. I don't know what happened.
Okay, you're still kind of in the outs a bit. So the viewers, can you see Natasha? If you can see Natasha, just give like a thumbs up if you can see her or hear her.
Can you see me?
It's jumbly.
It's jumbly. I'm not sure why. Yeah. I don't want to X out of it. Should I?
I know last time it just magically kind of came back. I'm not sure if it's going to do that again.
Sorry. Not sure. Yeah, that is very weird.
Oh, you're coming back. You're coming back. You're coming back now.
Okay, it's technology. It's technology, yeah. Unfortunately.
Yeah.
Am I back now?
What? Yes, you're back. You're back in full effect.
Okay.
No, but that was such a powerful, powerful story. I mean, it just really lets you just see through just hearing your experiences that you have to go through the process. And like you said, keeping in mind God's promise that all things work together. All things, you know, even those things that just seem like, you know, this is just it. But it took you there and it pressed you hard enough and it vexed you hard enough for you to kind of realize that, oh, it's now meant for me to go to the next level. Okay, Lord, I'm going. You know, but you have to have situations to kind of stir up not just the frustration, but just like you said, the confidence, you know, that I can actually go out there and do it. All those tools is right here inside of me.
Absolutely.
I mean, people just don't realize how much they are built for their purpose. You're built for the purpose.
You built for this. You're built for this.
Yes, you are. And thank you for sharing that. I mean, I was trying to hold back, you know, but I felt it.
Thank you.
On so many different levels. And I thank you for just that transparency, because you're right. This is what people are going through. You know, just like the first guest lost his whole business, you know, and had to rebuild, recreate, rebrand himself. But now it's better than before.
Look at that.
Yeah. So to the next question.
Trials only make us stronger. It only makes us stronger if we're willing to hold on.
Right. And it's so true. And sometimes, and this is another reason why I really wanted to do this platform, Natasha, is because people don't realize how much other people's story really does, like, help them and support them and encourage them and build them up. Like the life that you're speaking and to someone who felt like it was over, like that's life-changing. You know, I don't even think people realize how he blesses us for other people. You know what I'm saying? So we can impart that to other people.
Yes.
You know, but I cannot believe our time is coming to an end. Oh my
wow,
goodness.
That's fast.
Yeah, but you know, you have to, I want you to really go into some of the projects that you're working on, how people can participate, where they can find you, services. Like, I want you to kind of just go into all of that.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, you know what? Let me just say this. Am I blurry? Am I fine? Clear? Everything is good? I feel like I'm a little blurry because I'm not sure what, because it's kind of shady on my end on the way I look, but I don't, you know, I don't know. You tell me.
I mean, it's a bit of a glare, but I still see you compared to what was the technical issues.
Okay. Is that better?
Oh, wow. What did you do differently?
You know what? I think all this time it had that glare. I just wiped my screen.
It's perfect now.
Oh my gosh, at the very end. The nerve.
No. It was kind of doing, it just went that way after the second technical issue. But it was like that throughout, except when we had those technical issues.
Oh, it was had that glare for the whole time?
No, it did not. It's just okay. That last moment during the technical issue.
Oh, okay. So I just cleaned my actual screen. I guess it's on it. Okay, that's good. Perfect. Okay, awesome. Well, I just wanted to first say thank you so much for having me on your show, right? I'm blessed and humbled that you would think of me to support what it is that you're doing. I think it's a great thing. You are an exception as it relates to you just giving back and how you do what you do. I mean, you know, so for those who don't know, you know, I still call her Boston. I call her by her last name. Miss Boston, you know.
Not with you. Oh, yeah.
But I just want to say you are truly an inspiration to me, and how you continue to keep pushing and how you continue to do and literally create your own path. That is inspiring for not just a woman, but for the human race. Honestly, making decisions to say, I want something. I see that there's not what, I don't see that there are books available for, you know, for children as it relates to sexual trauma and to prevent it from happening. And you said, I don't see it, so let me create it, right? It takes boldness to do that. And I'm inspired by you. So I just want to say that. Thank you so much for that, really.
Thank you, Natasha. I appreciate it.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. In addition to that, what I just want to say is, you know, and I love how we can come together, because the thing is that it's about helping as many people as possible. When you help as many people as possible, guess what? When you give people what they want, you will eventually get what you want. That is a common universal law. You will eventually get what you want. And so how can people find me? Natasha Paris for you. Natasha, N-A-T-A-S-H-A, Paris, P-A-R-I-S, for you on IG. And I am, oh my gosh, I have a masterclass that starts this Tuesday. And I'm getting requests for people who want to be a part of a mat, because I have these webinars, these free webinars, and I'm going to do a webinar. Actually, I'm thinking about doing a webinar on Sunday, either Sunday or Monday. I'm not sure, but I think I'm going to do it on Monday at 5:30 for people to join so they can get information on the 6-week course. And really it is about getting people ready for 2021. So the question is, are you ready? Are you ready, Miss Boston?
But yes, I'm ready.
Because I'm going to be honest with you, there are lots of people who are not ready. They've gotten so bogged down by what has happened during 2020, and that they have now either gained a lot of weight because they've been eating and Netflixing, okay? or they have been in a severely depressed mood because they are unable to move like they're used to, right? Travel and do those things. And so we need to begin to look at this as an opportunity right now, the last month, December, to start shedding all of what has been holding us back during these 8 months, 9 months. Start letting it go. Start letting it go, because you don't wait till January 1st to say, I'm going to start. And so when people say, when you ask, what am I doing? Go to my Natasha Paris for You. And let's continue to talk about, you know, and I'm going to do a live after this because I'm super excited and pumped up. You know, let's talk about what can you do in preparation for 2021? What can you do now? What can you do now? Because again, 2021 will come just as quickly as it came, it will go. And remember, 1440, remember the number, 1440. 1440 is what? Is the number of minutes that every person has in a day. Once 1440 goes, you cannot capture those minutes again. So remember, every minute should be important to you. And this is the time when December hits Tuesday, really start working on shedding and letting go of all of the stuff that you've been holding on to during 2020, because 2021 is the year for many people. And I say that a change is here, because most businesses grow out of something that has happened. Depression, businesses like came out of it. I'm telling you, right? During wilderness experiences, like the darkness we had during this year, inevitably, greatness is right at it's right there, right there. Yes. When the tornado hits and it's raining, guess what happens when rain hits and it stops? A rainbow and the sun comes up. That's universal law. Nothing is the same. Everything is always changing. So are you ready for change that is prepared already for you? It will come. Now, if you don't know it's coming and you continue to do what you do, guess what? You're going to miss it.
No more missing it. No more missing it. I want all the opportunities and blessings that are destined for me. No more missing, you know? And so as we get ready to wind down, oh my goodness, this has been, I'm definitely going to go back and watch this again. And so the last question that I always ask every single guest is, what is that one empowering message that you would like to leave our community viewers?
Oh, I think I said it too, but I'll just expand. I just talked about it. Okay, so what would I say? I would say this, that you say an empowering message.
Empowering message, huh?
Yes, that you matter. That you matter. And that you deserve everything that you have asked for. Wow. You matter and you deserve it. So let's get up and get to it. And do not rely on your feelings. Do not rely on feelings. Do not rely on fear. Fear is what? Fear is false evidence appearing real. If you can cross over fear, understand there is something great on the other side. But if you subject yourself to fear and feelings, understand you will never move to your greatness. So you matter. You deserve all that God has in store for you. And remember, it is for your taking. Just go after it. I want to see businesses popping up. I want to see people making moves and networking and doing great things. Because remember, God is on your side and he will never leave you nor forsake you.
Yes. And on that note, thank you all who are able to tune in real time, or even if you catch it on the flip side. So as always, be well, be safe, and be blessed. Have a good night. Thank you, Natasha.
Good night, everyone. Thank you for having me. Bye.